How's it going, everyone? You got your boy Corey here, aka Crasher, bringing you guys a new video. And ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves an interesting video here today, because this is going to be sort of like a response slash discussion sort of video, and it involves YouTube's blog post in regards to the whole thing with the FTC and COPPA. So with that being said, let's go ahead and let's get into the video here. So in their blog post, their first paragraph reads the following: responsibility is our number one priority at YouTube, and this includes protecting kids and their privacy. Over the last few years, we've significantly invested in the policies, products, and practices to help us do this, including launching YouTube Kids in 2015. In July 2019, the Federal Trade Commission, or FTC for short, began accepting comments on the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act, or COPPA for short. Many creators have already participated in this process, and today we've submitted our comment to the FTC as well. Okay, so right from the opening statements, there is already some things off about this. Number one, they claim that responsibility is their number one priority, but if that were to be true, why is it that they knowingly violated COPPA and even bragged about it to advertisers by mentioning how their site was extremely popular among kids? That seems like a far cry from being responsible when you violate a federal law and more or less brag about it. How would you know that your site is popular among children? By tracking their data, which you cannot do. Also, you only now mention the YouTube Kids app after all this time pretending like it doesn't exist? The reason for that app in the first place is so kids can watch videos that are objectively meant and targeted to children. Anything that is deemed kids' content should have been relegated to that app rather than mixing it up with content that isn't meant for kids, which was a root cause for this problem in the first place. Now with that said, let's move on to the next section here, which covers support access to high quality kids content, and it states the following. YouTube is built on the premise of openness. Based on this open platform, millions of creators around the world have been able to make their content globally accessible for free to audiences of diverse backgrounds. On YouTube, creators are bringing visibility and opportunity to kids and families with special needs, using crafts to explore the world, offering fun ways to get kids moving, and more. Many creators have expressed concern about the complexity of COPPA, their ability to comply with it, and its effects on the viability of their businesses. Questions range from what content is directed at children to how to treat adults who might be watching kids' content. This is particularly difficult for smaller creators who might not have access to legal resources. Balanced and clear guidelines will help creators better comply with COPPA and live up to their legal obligations while enabling them to continue producing high-quality kids content that is accessible to everyone everywhere. Now, while I agree with a lot of what is said here in this section, I need to point this out. Your platform is not built on the premise of openness, because over the last several weeks, there have been so many questions regarding clarification on how COPPA will apply to YouTube, and there haven't been clear-cut answers from YouTube themselves. This is another example of them being vague and extremely uncaring of their creators, in my opinion, because YouTube also put out a video on November 12th talking about the FTC and COPPA, and there was a lot of vague points as well as coming off as extremely bad in the sense that they made it out to be our fault that data was collected from minors. This is not true in any way, because it was YouTube themselves that violated COPPA, and as a result, they threw us under the bus and acted like the FTC and COPPA were the bad guys, when in actuality, they weren't bad at all. YouTube essentially fired the kill shot at their community and placed a smoking gun in the hands of the FTC. Also, there is nothing clear and balanced when it comes to guidelines for creators. They also openly ignored COPPA as well, in the regards that the FTC knows that there are general audiences out there that enjoy things that both kids and adults like, such as gaming, cartoons, animations, music, etc. So with that said, let's move on here to the next section here in the blog, which covers treat adults as adults, and it states the following. Currently, the FTC's guidance requires platforms must treat anyone watching primarily child-directed content as children under 13. This does not match what we see on YouTube, where adults watch favorite cartoons from their childhood or teachers look for content to share with their students. Creators of such videos have also conveyed the value of product features that wouldn't be supported on their content. For example, creators have expressed the value of using comments to get helpful feedback from older viewers. This is why we support allowing platforms to treat adults as adults if there are measures in place to help confirm that the user is an adult viewing kids' content. So I will say, thank you for finally acknowledging the importance of engagement and age demographics. Let's take my age demographic as an example from my other channel, Crasher Plays and Reacts. As we can see, the youngest age bracket being 13 to 17 years of age reads as less than 12% of my overall audience, and we take a look at the percentage of people 18 and above who watch my content, we can clearly see after adding up the other age brackets that we have almost 90% of my viewers that are 18 and above, which is a far cry from my content being targeted towards children. My content is a mixture of gaming and reactions, such as Pokemon and Mario. While those sorts of subjects may appeal towards children from the outside, if we take a deep dive, we can clearly see that this isn't the case, as millions upon millions of adults are into the same things that kids may be into. This brings me back to a point I made earlier in the video involving general audiences. This needs to be a choice for us creators to be able to select, as a lot of our channels garner viewers from both kids and adults, hence general audience. So moving on to the next section here, which covers provide clarity on what is made for kids, and it states the following. The question creators ask us the most is, what is made for kids content? Sometimes content that isn't intentionally targeting kids can involve a traditional kids activity, such as DIY, gaming, and art videos. Are these videos made for kids even if they don't intend to target kids? This lack of clarity creates uncertainty for creators. The FTC shared some guidance in November, and while this is a positive step in the right direction, we believe there needs to be more clarity about when content should be considered primarily child-directed, mixed audience, or general audience. When providing these distinctions, it's important to not only consider the actual content of the video, but also its context. I agree with what is said here for the most part, however, I do need to point something out right here. The FTC may have been vague about this initially, but YouTube's response didn't exactly give us much clarity, if not anything at all. The FTC at least acknowledged the general audience exception, as there are millions of videos from creators and millions of channels that create videos meant for everyone, not exclusively kids or adults. YouTube hid that part from us, which was not the right thing to do. In order to be trustworthy, you need to be very transparent and clear to your community when something of this magnitude takes place. Dare I say that because of this, in combination with the lack of clarity from YouTube, many content creators have been in a major panic and even privated their videos and channels in fear of them being punished wrongfully. Some big creators even quit or are planning on quitting because of this mess, and it's not okay. I repeat, it's not okay. Now, with that said, I do acknowledge that YouTube is aware of there being mixed and general audiences, as well as the context of said content, which is a step in the positive direction. Let's keep it that way. So in the last section here, work with the FTC states the following. We strongly support COPPA's goal of providing robust protections for kids and their privacy. We also believe COPPA would benefit from updates and clarifications that better reflect on how kids and families use technology today while still allowing access to a wide range of content that helps them learn, grow, and explore. We continue to engage on this issue with the FTC and other lawmakers. We've previously participated in the FTC's public workshop and are committed to continue to do so. The comment period closes at Wednesday, December 11th. If you're interested in providing feedback of your own, you can do so on the FTC's website. Well, I'll be honest. It didn't seem like you supported COPPA when you not only violated COPPA law, but also knowingly did so and offhandedly bragged about it for the sake of commercial interest. You also made it look like the FTC and COPPA came after the platform for no reason when they did have a reason, and you treated being responsible for your major fuck-up like that last bit of spinach on your plate that your parents tell you to eat. You threw us under the bus and placed the responsibility on the creators to mark our content and channels as if we violated COPPA, in which we did not. We are content creators, not babysitters. We shouldn't have to be responsible for the kids who watch our videos because it's the parents' responsibilities of what their kids access online and for you to age gate the site effectively, not us. So anyways, fam, that's pretty much all I have to say here in regards to this video. Now, I will say, you know, at this point right here, we just pretty much have to sit back and wait. You know, we have to sit back and wait for full clarification. And I say clarification very, very loosely because a lot of this clarification has been very kind of spotty. You know, not a lot of us know truly what is going on. But at this point right here, we just gotta sit back and wait. You know, we just gotta sit back and wait until the final call takes place, and when 2020 rolls around, how YouTube will be affected by the implementation of COPPA. I'm hoping that we as creators can still do what we love to do for our fans and do best. That is to create content, entertain, and inspire. And that's all I want to do, man. That's all I want to do with my life is to entertain and inspire people. That's not too much to ask. That's not, you know, a bad thing or anything like that. And if it's something that I want to do, then it's pretty obvious, but I'm going to say this as well. Then there are thousands and thousands of people out there that want to do the same thing that I'm doing and keep on doing so for as long as possible, you know? So with that being said, my best advice is to just not stress out anymore about it, you know? Don't spend your energy stressing out and having anxiety about this. You know, at this point right here, we just gotta lay back and wait for things to fall into place and figure something out from there, you know? The thing is that we only have so much control. Now it's up to the FTC and COPPA to be able to put two and two together and for there to be a bright future for YouTube and us creators in the year 2020. Clear vision, clear sight. It's kind of funny how the year 2020 is what it is, and you got 2020 vision, you know? Clear sight, clear vision. And I have clear sight and clear vision that 2020 is, in fact, going to be a good year. I have a lot of optimism going into 2020, and I hope that we as a community will continue to have that optimism in 2020. So with that being said, guys, that's all I have to say. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like and subscribe. There most likely will be more videos to come in regards to the subject in particular when it comes to updating you guys on anything that is relevant that you guys need to be privy to. So with that said, thank you for watching. Have yourself a damn awesome day or night, depending on your time zone. And I'll see you guys in the next one.